days and reviewed my previous session of doing pike pull-ups, and I'm thinking I can't be bothered. But I did want to do the pike push-ups today, so I'm going to go through it with it anyway. Not do 50 reps, but instead do 100 reps to see where my weaknesses lie. Because I'm testing out a theory that if I do 100 reps, I should at least eventually be able to see where I could improve and what's going wrong. For example, where in terms of strength, which part of the body is the weakest during a pike push-up, for example, and things of that nature. All right, let's try one rep, even though I'm thinking I can't be bothered. Usually it'd be my shoulders, like I found during the knee push-ups. Technique as well, I don't really even know what I'm doing. Maybe if I show it from the side, that'd help, but that's at least one. It's hot, man. To be fair, we are in the peak of summer, so it does make sense. Wearing this hoodie and nothing else under it is like wearing a jacket, even when it's not needed. Alright, let's show you that side angle. Oh no, there's not enough space. I'll just go on the wood. On the patio that the camera stood on. Okay, now let's try. Right, these cookies there. What are you doing for mud? Right, legs fully extended. Now just push. Right, that's two. Yeah, strength. It's the shoulders. This would really help with me. This would really help me build shoulder strength. But right now, shoulders, I'm not having it. If I work on my technique, that'd help. I just want to get these reps out of the way. Oh, actually, to make it seem like it's not near enough impossible to do 100 attempts, I'm gonna try and do it in 20 minutes. I'll start the timer. Okay, I've just gotten rid of the previous session. Here we go, so I've done two. Let's try and get to 100 within 20 minutes, even if the reps aren't proper, and that's fine. I know I don't know what I'm doing. That's three. Is that as far as I really can go? I don't think, in previous attempts of trying to do pike push-ups, I don't think I'd be having my feet as close to my hands as I should for it to be a proper rep. And I think I'm doing the same thing here. So technique needs a lot of work, and strength in my shoulders needs a lot of work. What can I do to help myself out here? Just like I do knee push-ups, I could do, why not try doing knee pike push-ups? There you go. I'm counting that as a rep. Anything goes with these reps. Anything that's helping me progress, that counts. So that's three. It's kind of like, so in my head, I'm now realizing, so that's about, it's about six now. Before, during the reps, before just trying to do it on my knees, my head would be around about here. And then I'd try and do it like that, but I sense it just seems more natural to just go more down, slightly diagonal, but not extremely diagonal like I was trying to do earlier, like this, but just with my knees off the ground. Okay, so I'll start here then. So I say starting from, try and do four reps. I'll do four reps, and that'll be first 10 done. I sense I'm getting somewhere now. Imagine if I did act on those thoughts about me saying I can't be bothered. Now I'm getting to something now I'm doing something I don't find so difficult, which is why I didn't want to do the reps. It looks rotten, but it's definitely not. This is definitely fresh. It's just been out in the air. So we've got 9 sets of 10 left. 2 minutes 52 seconds. 9 sets of 10 reps, that is. I'll definitely make some note that I can do pike push-ups on my knees to begin with to help me with technique. Might have come with you with the session I've got, mate. That's at least 13 reps. Okay. It's okay, that was hard. 4 minutes, 36 seconds. Okay, now let's try normal pike push-ups, see if that's helped. Took my slippers off, so I think I'll focus on my forward. I think I've pointed my feet out during normal push-ups when I have my slippers on more compared to if I don't. Okay, so I've got to keep my arms close to my side and really go out of my way to push my shoulders. Yep, strength, that's rep four, attempt 14 count. Okay, I definitely need to work on my shoulder strength. So arms close by my side, 4 more reps until 20, arms close by my side, try and get my arm to bend at 90 degrees at the elbow. Okay, now I'm creating guides for myself. This is my working my shoulders quite a bit actually.
Wow, okay.
So that's 20. So even if I do negatives, I'm gonna count them as a rep. Because it's helping me progress. So I could work on getting to this point in normal pike push-up position without my knees on the floor. And just calm down. With control. Like that. That counts. Now I'm actually really, really, really getting somewhere. I try and do the reverse. Do the opposite. Oh, that doesn't count as a rep. You can see shoulder strength. So I've done at least 20 reps. I'll call that negative 21st rep. Okay. So I'll try and do one full pike push-up rep. Let's see how that goes. line with both head in line with both my hands. Try and get my elbows to bend 90 degrees. You know, try and get my arms to bend 90 degrees to the elbow. I might actually get my proper first pike push-up rep, even though it might not be the most ideal form. It might not look the prettiest, but hey, it's something. Left shoulder. It doesn't feel like it's going to pop out of place, but it just feels so difficult for my left shoulder to do. Right, I'm counting that as a rep, that was an attempt. So that's 22. Gotta control it more. Gotta control that rep more. It's like my body wants to lean. I'll let it. Right, that's another attempt, that's 23. Even though they're failed reps, it's something. Getting somewhere. Be more lenient with myself than I usually would because I know how difficult I find this. Right, to get to 30, let's do 7 more reps. Right, get it in the face. Now let's go. Okay, well, I looked at the last proper pike push-up attempt, or normal pike push-up attempt, and I caved at the knee, so maybe I can make it a non-negotiable rule to not cave at the knee, so that I don't keep bailing out on the reps and allow myself to get stronger that way. So I can focus on keeping my hamstrings as extended as I can easily weight them. Okay. I've just noticed in that rep, when I do the try and do the pike push up, it's easier to do when I keep my hands when I keep my elbows closer to my side and let my chest work too. So I can try that with the normal pike push ups, which I wasn't doing before. Oh, I just said no knee caving. My knees want to cave in so much. So much. Minutes 31 seconds. Right, well, I'm just going to do knee push-ups from now, otherwise I won't get the reps done. I just went out my way to feel chest activation on that rep, and that was, I think, the easiest rep out of all of them so far. It's still working my shoulders as well though. So I could treat it like getting into a normal push-up position here, but instead just let my knees come up like this rather than like this. Alright, okay. So push-up position, set up, activate my chest. I said no knee caving, but I think that's my best attempt yet. 13 minutes, 38 seconds. I don't think I'm getting 100 reps. Well, I'll do knee ones anyway. I was just placing my hands anywhere during pike push-ups, but now that I'm setting up, activate my chest and treating it like a normal push-up, up to this point where I just stand up, now I think I'm genuinely getting somewhere with it. you might not have seen that. So I activate my chest like I'm doing a normal push-up, and I just let my knees come off the ground like this, rather than like this. Obviously my feet would be straight, but because of what's behind me, can't do that. And then do the work. Chest activation. Wait, just a check. Yep. Oh, definitely getting there. I don't think I even need to do 100 reps. I've got to keep going anyway, because I said 100. I don't even want to look at the time right now, I just want to go. I think that's at least 3 tries, so we're on 33. I'm just going to do knee pike push-ups from now on. Because it's way easier for me at the moment. It always will be easier because I'm lifting less weight, because my legs are just in the air. But okay, let's get into these reps. So that was 34. I've got to remember, just like how I did that rep before, keep my elbows close to my side, or otherwise I'm making it more difficult to do, by activating my muscles less and using less of the power that I do have and the strength that I do have. Left wrist, or be careful. 4 more to this 40. Chest activated, let's go. Too close, got 130. I just want to stop, and I can, but I'm not going to make the progress I could make if I don't keep going. 60 minutes, 12 seconds. Forget the timer, let's just do the reps. Just so that I don't see it flip the watch. 6 more sets of 10 left. Halfway there. Wow. I'm done. I'm going to call it quits. Or do I? As you know, at this point, before these reps I've just done, around maybe 40 rep mark. But now I think I'm just too deep in that. I want to finish this. To go. Maybe I should just stop. I've made more progress than I usually would with pike push-ups. Thank you. 100 means 100, not half. Unless I'm overtraining, that is. But I don't think I am here. There's 53. Oh. I might actually stop because of this wrist pain. I'll do 6 reps and then I think I'll finish. I've made progress. No knee caving in. That's one thing I'd say. And also, get into push-up position properly and then do pike push-ups. That's the main 2 things I've taken away from doing the reps and trying to work up to 100. Right, let's do these 6. That is 4 lifts and 56. Oh, I think I'm feeling that pain in my left wrist because of my hands are like this. They're not placed right in front of me because the patio is slanted. I need to really move the mat to the left so I don't do that where it's flat. That should help. Let's just try one rep. So we're at 60 now. No, not really. No, it hasn't helped. Upper back is hurting me as well. Right here. Oh, they can't see that. Right here. Stop. Now, even though I could stop as I'm experiencing wrist and spine pain, but I haven't been tensing my abs this whole time, so maybe I won't experience that if I do that. And if I play about with hand positioning, so instead of doing this, do this instead, that might help make it easier on the wrists. So I could do both, tense my abs on the way up and down, and also adjust hand positioning. So we're at 61 reps. Let's just try that for one rep. Let's see. It does a little bit. It does help a little bit, but hand position is helping, but I didn't tense my abs, so let's try that again. So this will be rep 63. I have noticed though that it does help me bring my elbows closer to my side though. Okay. 36 left, come on. Almost there. Let's just do the 6 and then take it in 10 sets of 3. Nah, still hurting my wrist. I've been pulling it. Four more until 70. Still counts though. I think the battery, because the battery is really low, I've got to end it here on this camera. We're on rep 67. So it's gonna be this is gonna be it for it being on the camera, but I'm gonna just film the rest on the phone. So cheers to that happening, making that happen and going on even though we've got this technical difficulty. So that's it. Peace.